Welcome to another Tutor Short provided by the Educational Support Services Department of Lehigh Carbon Community College in Snecksville, Pennsylvania, which is just outside of Allentown. These videos review key learnings for the science courses provided here at LTRIC. And please remember that the Educational Support Services Department does provide walk-in tutoring 5 days a week.
This is a tutor short on the structures of the skull, given to you by your tutors, Laura Heck and Kim Rylander. We will start off by going over the frontal bone, which is located here. You can also see from this view the sphenoid bone, which is located here. In the medial portion of the orbit, you can see the lacrimal bone, located here. And also on this side. You can also notice the zygomatic bone, located here. And the nasal bone, located here. Another portion of the skull and the facial bones is the maxilla, which is this region. The mandible bone is down here. If you look inside the nasal cavity, you can see the nasal concha. Here you can notice the inferior nasal concha and the middle nasal concha. There's also a superior nasal concha located up in this region. You can see the vomer, located here. These structures are known as the infraorbital foramen. Down here, you can see the mental foramen. And above the orbit is the supraorbital foramen. Posterior to the eye, you can see the superior orbital fissure, located here. Cranial nerves 3, 4, and 6, which control the extraocular movements of the eye, run through this fissure, along with the ophthalmic branch of cranial nerve 5 and ophthalmic blood vessels. Here I will point out our first suture. Sutures on this skull, you can see, are interlocking joints that form a firm union between the bones of the skull. Here is the frontonasal suture. It interlocks the frontal bone up here and the nasal bones here. From this view, we will name a few more structures. Again, note the lacrimal bone here. The lacrimal bone contains a lacrimal sac, and lacrimation is also known as crying. Here you can see the ethmoid bone, and here is the temporal bone. The temporal bone has this structure known as the zygomatic process that attaches to the zygomatic bone here. This suture is known as the squamous suture. From this view, you can also see part of the sphenoid bone. Looking down now at the mandible, you can notice the angle of the mandible. You can see the nasal bone, and you can also see part of the coronal suture. Looking behind where your ear sits, you can see the mastoid and your external acoustic meatus. This is a view of the skull looking down from the top. You can see your coronal suture, the frontal bone, the parietal bones, part of the occipital bone, your sagittal suture, and your lambdoid suture. From this view, you can now see your styloid process. Again, the mastoid process. Your zygomatic process. You can also see your mandibular condyle, which sits in the mandibular fossa. And this forms your temporomandibular joint. The angle of the mandible, again, external acoustic meatus, the coronoid process, and the mandibular notch. Again, this is your sphenoid bone. This is a better view to see your styloid process. Mastoids, zygomatic process, foramen magnum. The foramen magnum allows the spinal cord to travel through it from the brainstem to the vertebral canal. You can see part of your occipital bone, and you can even see your nasal concha. You can see your pterygoid process. And your mandibular fossa, which is where your mandibular condyle forms the temporomandibular joint. Here you can see your jugular foramen, where your internal jugular vein travels. You can also see your carotid canals, where your internal carotid arteries bring blood up through to your head. Here you can see your foramen spinosum. You can see your foramen ovale and your foramen lacerum. You can also see your vomer. In this view, I'm going to point out your anterior, middle, and posterior fossa. Anterior fossa, middle fossa, and posterior fossa. This area is also your frontal bone and your ethmoid bone, which is made up of your cribriform plate and your crista galli. Your olfactory nerves, also known as your cranial nerve 1, runs down through the cribriform plate. This butterfly-shaped bone is your sphenoid bone. And here is your hypophyseal fossa of the sella turcica, which means Turk's saddle. You can also see your parietal bones and the petrous part of your temporal bone. Petrous means rocky, so it sort of looks like a rocky mountainous ridge. And here's your occipital bone. You can see your foramen magnum, your foramen lacerum, your foramen ovale. Through your foramen ovale, your trigeminal nerve runs through. It is the mandibular branch of the trigeminal nerve. Here's your foramen spinosum. Your middle meningeal artery runs through the foramen spinosum. And your foramen rotundum. The maxillary branch of your trigeminal nerve, also known as cranial nerve 5, runs through the foramen rotundum. You can see your optic canals, through which your optic nerves run, and you can see your internal acoustic meatus, through which cranial nerves 7 and cranial nerve 8 run. And here you can see your jugular foramen. Your internal jugular vein, cranial nerves 9, 10, and 11 run through the jugular foramen. Thanks for watching. To view these models, or if you have any questions, please come to SH 150 in the Educational Support Services Center.